Once again, I'm a little depressed by the tired old face that I see. Once again, it is time to be someone who is anyone other than me. With a rare combination of girlish excitement and manly restraint, I position my precious assortment of pencils and powders and paint. So whenever I feel that my place in the world is beginning to crash, I apply one great stroke of mascara to my rather limp upper lash. And I can cope again. Good God, there's hope again. When life is a real bitch again, and my old sense of humor has up and gone, it's time for the big switch again. I put a little more mascara on. When I count my crow's feet again and tire of this perpetual marathon, I put down the John seat again and put a little more mascara on. And everything sparkle dust, bugle bee, ostrich plume, when it's a beaded lash that you look through. 'Cause when I feel glamorous, elegant, beautiful, the world that I'm looking at, beautiful too. When my little road has a few bumps again, and I need something level to lean upon, I put on my sling pumps again. And wham! This ugly duckling is a swan. So when my spirits start to sag, I hustle out my highest drag and put a little more mascara on. And everything's ankle straps, Marabou, Shalimar, is worth sucking in my gut and girdling my rear. 'Cause everything's ravishing, sensual, fabulous, when Alban is tucked away and Zaza is here. When everything slides down the old tube again, and when my self-esteem has begun to drift, I strap on my fake boots again and literally give myself a lift. So when it's cold and when it's bleak, I simply rouge the other cheek, for I can face another day in slipper satin lingerie too. Make depression disappear. I threw some rhinestones on my ear and put my brooches and tiara and a little more mascara on. Ankle strap, marabou. Bonnie's tucked away and Zaza's here. When everything slides down the old tubes again, and when my self-esteem has begun to slip.
Only 7 minutes late? Not bad for the first show.
Well, no matter how old Zaza may be, she's still got style.
I know how old she is, and all she's still got is nerve.
Cheap, Mercedes, cheap.
Now, George, you know Zaza can't dance.
With a voice like that, she doesn't have to dance.
And with a dress like that, she doesn't have to sing.
Attention! I have just received a supply of fuchsia pheasant feathers.
You know, it's funny, Pedro. You could work with someone for years and years and never really get to know her.
Oh, Derma, Derma, Derma. Does anybody ever really know anybody ever really at all?
At least they're not on drugs. You're the butler.
The maid, we agreed.
Jacob?
Claudine, or you don't get your surprise.
Surprise? I love surprises. Tell me, what surprise, Jacob?
Who?
Oh, Claudine.
You know how you're always telling the folks at the club to
open your eyes?
Well, I am telling vous.
Moi?
Oui! To close your eyes.
Right.
And voila!
My life, my love, my heaven.
My, my.
How I missed you.
I've missed you too.
Isn't it wonderful? Our son is home.
What do you mean, our son?
Oh, Papa, please, I just walked in the door. I must say, I do like the outfit, Claudine, but, what is it you're dressed for?
Dressed to serve your every need. Oh, that's for me, this for you, and this for your papa.
Papa always gets the best part.
Don't you dare laugh, you'll only encourage him.
Oh, he only behaves that way because he loves you.
If he loved me, he'd vacuum. Look at this place, it's disgusting.
God, it's good to be home.
Well, it's wonderful to have you back. I know you've only been on holiday for a few weeks, but to this old man's heart, it seemed forever.
Well, I won't be here long. Papa, I'm getting married.
Oh. This is what I like most about you. No hemming, no hawing. You have something to say, you say it clearly, precisely, right to the point, like a knife in the heart.
and I was worried you weren't going to take it well.
You were right.
You mean you're not pleased for me?
I don't think so. Perhaps I'm working up to it. All right, tell me, who is it you're going to marry, not that Angelique?
Her name is Anne, Papa.
Don't change the subject. You go on holiday for 3 weeks with this Anisette, and all of a sudden you're getting married, Jean-Michel. You're only 20 years old. You still have time for other women besides this Antoinette.
Her name is Anne, and I'm 24.
Are you sure?
Papa, sit down. I have a little problem.
24? So do I.
Well, you see, it's Anne's parents. Her father's Dindon. Edouard Dindon? Deputy General of the TFM?
You know me in politics. What's the TFM?
The Tradition, Family, and Morality Party?
I like the sound of that. There's a little bit of everything in there.
Not terribly compatible with La Cage aux Folles.
The deputy in the family, we could use a little political clout. What with that idiot who's running for office? You know the one who's threatening to close down all the transvestite clubs if elected.
His name is Dindon. Edouard Dindon. Deputy General of the TFM. And he's on his way here to meet you.
You're insane.
He, his wife, and Anne will be spending the night.
They're probably certifiable.
They'll be here for cocktails tomorrow.
Definitely dangerous.
Papa, Anne is nothing like her father, so there's nothing to worry about.
Except her father.
Look, we got a lot of work to do. We should probably start ditching a few of the more obvious ironies in the decor.
And while we're ditching ironies, what is to become of me?
Oh, I took care of that. I told him you were at the French Foreign Service. Retired, of course. Don't worry, I was very vague.
If you can't be truthful, be vague.
Let's see, I figure we can close off the door to the club and they can use the house entrance.
And what is Alban to be? A French attaché to Fire Island?
Anyone he wants to, as long as he's not here. Papa, you know the way he is, the way he moves, the way he dresses, you know!
Oh, so all of a sudden it's farewell to Alban. The man who raises you like a mother for 20 years, all of a sudden you turn around and say, I'm engaged to the daughter of a fanatic. So this for me, that for you, and Papa always gets the best part, Judas!
Papa!
Traitor!
Papa, please!
Collaborationist!
Well, from your point of view, maybe. But there's no one like Anne.
Nonsense. You've been in love a dozen times.
Not like this.
No? What about Helene? Paulette?
No one. Not like this.
Oh. She's a witch!
Yes. She is. Girls have come and gone, Papa. Angelique and Antoinette. Who did I prefer? Leslie or Helene? It was all a blur, and yet, Papa, when Anne comes running down the street, and I link my arm in hers, girls have come and gone, girls may come and go, but something very odd occurs, Papa, 'cause life is in perfect order with Anne on my arm. It makes my shoulders broader with Anne on my arm. Even when things won't gel and the pieces won't fit, I'm suddenly in, I'm suddenly on, I'm suddenly it. Who else can make me feel like I'm handsome and tall? Who else can make me feel I'm on top of it all? I found a combination that works like a charm. I'm simply a man who walks on the stars whenever it's Anne on my arm. Life is a celebration with you on my arm. A walking's a new sensation with you on my arm. Each time I face a morning that's boring and bland, with you it looks good, with you it looks great, with you it looks grand. Somehow a permanent star in my eye. Even the dead of winter can feel like July. got a conflagration that's cause for alarm. We're giving off sparks, we're setting off bells whenever it's you on my arm. Like I'm handsome and tall? Who else can make me feel I'm on top of it all? I found a combination that works like a charm. I'm simply a man who walks on the stars. Whenever it's an on my arm.
You make quite a convincing case. Just one more little thing?
Oh, please. I beg you. No more little things.
Well, the Dindons are coming to meet my parents.
Oh, so you said.
So I'd like to invite Mother.
Mother who?
Mother Sybil, my mother?
You haven't seen her for 20 years. Why do you want to invite her?
Well, I don't, but the Dindons are coming to meet my parents.
So?
I need a mother and she's my mother.
So?
Would you call and ask her to come?
And what do we do with Alban if she comes? Put him in a hotel?
I love you.
You had better. But who tells Alban?
Wedding bells? Do I hear wedding bells?
Jacob strikes again.
George, what have we raised? An animal? Snakes live male and female together. Cats live male and female together. We are human beings. We know better. What would you talk about?
What do we talk about? You can't reason with him when he's like this. Run, fool, run. I love her, Alban.
So why couldn't you tell me yourself? Why must I hear about my own son on the street? Look at you. Look how thin you are. You haven't been eating. It's that girl.
It's not the girl.
Her name is Anne.
Well, you always tell me I'm too thin.
Because you always are. Oh. Now you march right into that kitchen and have Claudine make you some good hot soup.
Alban.
I'll talk to him.
I'm sorry, Alban.
He's sorry. Oh, George. Our baby is getting married. Where, oh, where did we go wrong?
Now, my love, we've lived through worse in our time. We will get through this. Say, there's still an hour before the second show. Let's say you and I just go for a little stroll.
Oh, I couldn't possibly take one tiny little step.
With me you could. Life is a celebration with you on my arm.
I'm too upset.
That's because you're not listening.
It is not. I am too listening.
Life is a celebration with you on my arm. It's worth the aggravation with you on my arm.
Well, you always did bounce back quicker.
Oh, that's because I'm more limber.
You always were.
Each time I face a morning that's boring and bland, with you it looks good.
I can't dance.
Yes, you can. With you it looks great.
Do I have to?
Yes, with you it looks grand.
Ah, like the old days.
Ah.
you, it looks good. On you, it looks great. On you, it looks great. I found a combination that works like a charm. It suddenly, oh. Whatever, it's you.